Howdy, it's time for Flippin Science. We're looking at titrations. So the science understanding we're going to look at, a titration can be used to determine the concentration of a solution of a reactant in a chemical reaction. So we're going to describe and explain the procedure involved in carrying out a titration, particularly rinsing glassware and determining endpoint. So let's go to a video of doing that. So we're going to go through rinsing the burette and the pipette. We're going to start with the pipette. Remove the pipette from the burette clamp. Place the pipette filler on top. Be very careful when you do this so you don't hurt yourself. Evacuate the pipette by squeezing the top valve and emptying out the bulb. Now we're going to half fill the bulb of the pipette by pressing the S valve, so underneath the bulb, until it sucks up and half the bulb is filled. So we can see the halfway filling of the bulb. Carefully remove the pipette filler and place your thumb on the end of the pipette so the water doesn't leak out. And rotate the pipette, making sure you're coating the inside of the pipette's bulb with water. And then hold over a sink, take your thumb off the end and let it drain out. This rinses the inside with water. Let's repeat that process. Let's evacuate. I like that sound. It's important to remember not to have your face over the pipette filler when you evacuate that top bulb. Now this time we're going to fill the pipette until well above the etched line. So at the moment I'm depressing the S valve to suck water in. It's about to go up above the etched line. And as I bring it closer, we can see that it's well above the etched line. Now I'm going to take the pipette over to the sink. I'm going to remove the pipette filler and I'm going to drain out. You need to repeat this process, both rinsing up halfway through the bulb and then above the etched line, at least once with the solution that you're going to place into the pipette. This prevents dilution of that solution. Now we're going to fill up the burette, so we're going to rinse the burette. So place the funnel on top, make sure you close the stopcock down the bottom. Then we're going to fill. Make sure you hold the funnel slightly above the burette when you do this, otherwise you'll get an airlock. You want to add about 5 mL of water to your burette. So now we're going to take the burette out, and we're going to carefully tilt it on its side, and then we're going to rotate the burette. Whilst we're doing this, we're making sure the end of the burette is over a sink so that if any solution comes out, it will go down the sink. Then I'm going to put the burette back into the burette clamp and drain out the remaining solution. This process needs to be repeated again with the solution to be used to prevent dilution. Now, let's get started on the titration. This is the equipment we're going to use to do our titration. We have beakers of acid and base, a funnel, a pipette filler, conical flask, white tile, distilled water, a burette, and a pipette. In a stand. First we need to fill our burette, make sure the stopcock down the bottom is closed and you've placed a funnel in the top of the burette. We're assuming the burette's already being rinsed with the solution we're using, in this case it's base. Gently lift the funnel to allow air to flow in and out. Slowly tip in your solution into the burette, using the funnel to guide it in. You fill up until you get to around about 5 mL in the burette. You don't need to get to zero, that's not necessary. Once you've added, you shake your funnel a little bit to get rid of any final drips. Then you place the funnel in your beaker. Now we're going to look at how to use a pipette filler. There are several valves on the pipette filler. We're going to use the one at the top. You squeeze that and press in on the bulb, and that evacuates the bulb and allows you to suck up solution. Then place the pipette filler on the end of the pipette carefully. Carefully place your pipette into the solution, making sure it's not touching the bottom of the beaker. Then press the valve that's directly underneath the bulb to start sucking up solution. Keep sucking until you go well above the graduation line. Remove the pipette filler and use your finger on top of the pipette, gently moving the pipette to let a little bit of air in until you get the meniscus exactly on the graduated line. Place the pipette over the conical flask you intend on using and remove your finger. Let the pipette drain out, usually pointing it at the side of the conical flask. As it drains out, it will get down to the bottom. Gently tap it to the side of the conical flask to remove any last drops on the end. There should be one drop remaining in the bottom of the pipette, leave that there. Before using your burette, check for an air bubble in the bottom. To get rid of the air bubble, place the beaker of, in this case, base underneath, and gently open the stopcock and close it. That will get rid of the air bubble down the bottom so that we have the right volume in the burette. Read off your initial value, in this case, 3.8 mils. Add several drops of indicator, in this case phenolphthalein. Drop, drop, drop. Place the conical flask underneath the bottom of the burette and position the burette so that you can easily access the stopcock. This grip allows you to control the flow of solution and also swirl the conical flask as you add solution. So gently open the tap, swirl the conical flask as you're adding, and keep doing this. Control the flow rate, so to a few drops every second or so. You'll start to see the solution at the bottom change colour as the drops are added. Keep adding and swirling, looking for the pink colour to start to hang around a bit longer before it disappears. As you get closer and closer to the endpoint, it's a good idea to rinse off the inside of the conical flask and the end of the burette to make sure that all the solution added from the burette makes its way into the mixture down the bottom. Give it a good swirl once you've done that. Really close now, we're getting a pink colour that's hanging around for quite a while before it disappears. So again, we're adding drop by drop at this stage. Rinse off the burette, in this case we're rinsing off the end of the burette to get the last drop in there. Rinse off the side of the conical flask as well is a good idea. Give it a shake and see if the pink colour hangs around or disappears. In this case, once we let it sit for a little while, the pink colour does slowly disappear. So we need to add about one more drop. So very carefully, we're going to add in a drop. And there it is. It's right on the end of the burette. Give the burette a bit of a tap to see if it goes in. It doesn't, so we're just going to rinse off the end of the burette, give it a shake, and see what happens to the colour. So we've got our pink colour that we're looking for. Give it a shake, let it sit, and pop the tile behind it, and that's a permanent colour change. So that's the end point of the titration. Read off the final value from the burette, in this case 24.9 millilitres. Today on Flippin Science, we did an example titration. That's it, Flippin Science today. See ya.